Hi, this is Dr. Nemechek. I'm the inventor of the Nemechek protocol for autonomic dysfunction, autism, and developmental disorders. I want to talk to you about inflammation and how the system can break down from the unique perspective of how the autonomic nervous system gets damaged and how that contributes to this. So we're finding that there's a thing called the Cholinergic anti-inflammatory pathway, or CAP, or they'll call it the vagal inflammatory reflex. Basically, what this means is the so we've discussed in other videos, the autonomic nervous system has these two branches, these two signals coming out of the brain. One is called sympathetic, and one is called parasympathetic. The parasympathetic signal travels down through the vagus nerve, okay? And that signal controls inflammation. It's like a brake on your white blood cells. If you think of your white blood cells as like a bunch of soldiers that want to just go mix it up and go cause some trouble, the brain actually calms them. It keeps them in the barracks, so to speak. And you need that. Now, if normally, if you sprain your ankle, what happens is the brain can detect that there's damage out there, and we need some white blood cells to help fix the ankle, or this even happens when you have an infection. And so this parasympathetic signal that goes down the vagus nerve is weakened, and your inflammatory response turns on, okay? And these white blood cells now, they get in the bloodstream, they start reacting with things, they can actually find the say, sprained ankle and fix, and then the brain can detect when that damage is done, and it puts its foot back on the brake. So it's this kind of braking mechanism. Now, I've talked about the omega-3s and 6s. They're down there, if you want to think of them, kind of like wrenches. So the brain, through the vagus parasympathetic signal, through the vagus nerve, allows inflammation to occur. White blood cells go there. They use these omega-6s, kind of like wrenches, to fix things. They use omega-3s to turn the whole dang thing off after the brain has sent a signal to tell everybody to stop being inflammatory and go home. So that's kind of basically, it's this braking mechanism coming out of the brain. Now, what happens when that breaks? What happens when you get autonomic damage you don't recover from and it affects your parasympathetics? Okay, well, one of the major things that you develop much more inflammation throughout the body. That's what happens. I mean, your master controlling mechanism is now broken. So you get more joint pain, muscle pain, any inflammatory pain. You know, the damage to your blood vessels before you get a stroke and heart attack is from inflammation, all right? In large part, that should have been controlled by your brain, but isn't, okay? So there's all sorts of chronic depression, PTSD. These are chronic inflammatory disorders. Now, they may have been triggered by an emotional event, but you don't recover because you have chronic inflammation. And then there are things called autoimmune disorders. Now, what we're learning is, and we have evidence of this, is that for rheumatoid arthritis and Crohn's disease in particular, you have to have autonomic damage. And that parasympathetic, that inflammatory reflex, has to break before you can get rheumatoid arthritis or before you can get Crohn's disease. And talking to some of the research in this field, their inclination is this is probably going to hold true for almost all of the autoimmune disorders, that you have to have damage in the brain, damage of your autonomic nervous system first before you can even get, you know, rheumatoid arthritis, okay? And so that means in reverse, if you have these autonomic, autoimmune disorder, you probably already have some brain injury that you didn't recover from. And that means you already have an inflammatory disorder in the brain that from, you know, how did it get injured? Physical injury, emotional trauma, you know, the inflammatory traumas of like vaccines or surgeries or fractures. These kind of things will damage your brain. And if things work right, though, you fully recover in 2 weeks. But if you have this underlying problem that we discussed with the Nemechek protocol, which is mainly excessive omega-6s, you got inflammation coming from bacterial overgrowth from the gut, you may have inflammation coming from tobacco smoke or some other environmental thing that your brain gets injured and you can't recover. Okay, now you leave some residual damage up there, and as that builds, pretty soon you get to the point where the parasympathetics are so damaged they can't control inflammation at all. you have this highly dysregulated inflammatory response, and boom, autoimmune disorder. Okay? Has to happen before Crohn's, has to happen before rheumatoid, probably has to happen before everything. So, brain health is everything. Fix the brain, fix the body. That's what we're all about. You got to fix and maintain a healthy autonomic nervous system to control the all your health in your entire body. Alrighty. So this is Dr. Patrick Nemechek of Nemechek Consultative Medicine in Buckeye, Arizona. You can find us at nemechekconsultativemedicine.com. Have a great day. Bye.